In this video, I teach you impact of jack on a moving vertical head plates with the animation. In this video, we see the animations of a moving vertical plate, find out the force effects, then after work done and efficiency. So this is the pipe. At the end of the pipe, we fit the nozzles. From the nozzles, water is coming with the high velocity, so it's have high kinetic energy, and this is the moving vertical plates. How we say that it is a moving or a fixed plate? So if we draw the symbol here, then it is the fixed plate, but we are not drawing here any symbols, then it is known as the moving plate. So water coming out from the nozzles with the velocity V, its unit is meter per second, and the plate is moving with the velocity u in a meter per second. So here we learn that the water coming out from the nozzles with velocity v, so up to the certain quantity of the waters, plate is does not move, but when we increase the flow rate of the water q, then the plate is start to move with the velocity u. Okay, and it's get its new position, or it's continuously rotated with the velocity u, and then after the water is leaving from the surface of a plate, and it is a outlet at a perpendicular to the direction of z, and its outlet velocity is v minus u, and the velocity of the plate is u. So at the which velocity the jet of water is striking to the plate. So in a moving plate case, the water it strike to the plate at the velocity, it is known as the relative velocity, and relative velocity is v minus u. Okay, so jet is strike with relative velocity, and when the both the jet as well as the object is moving in the same directions, then we take the here minus, that is a v minus u. So that is strike with velocity v minus u. So we learn the parameters. V is the velocity of the jet, u is the velocity of this plate u, then d is diameter of the jet. From diameter we find out the area by pi by 4 d square, then m is equal to mass flow rate of a fluid. In a case of a fixed plate, we are considering the mass is equal to density into area into velocity, but in this case the equation of the mass is changed. M is equal to rho A in bracket capital V minus small u. So here we consider the relative velocity, because water does not strike with velocity V, but it is strike with the velocity is V minus u, and it's called as the relative velocity. Now we find the force, then work done and efficiency. Before that, I request you to subscribe my channels if you not subscribe, and like my video and share with your friend. So I again use these figures. Then we find out the force in a x direction. So we finding out force in x direction, that's why it is known as the Fx. So force exerted by a jet on a moving plate in direction of the jet. So here we using the Newton's second law of motion equations. F is equal to mass into acceleration, and F is equal to rate of change of momentum in direction of force. Then after it is divided that initial momentum minus final momentum divided by time, and momentum is the mass into velocity. So it is a mass into initial velocity minus mass into final velocity divided by time. We take the mass common. So mass into initial velocity means velocity of jet before striking, that means here, minus velocity of jet after striking, means after striking what the velocity of the jet in a x directions, not in any directions, it is only in x direction, because we finding the force in x direction. We know the equation of mass, that is a rho A in bracket v minus u. What is the velocity of jet before striking? That is a v minus u. And what is the velocity of jet after striking? It is a zero or a v minus u. So it is a zero, because the v minus u is a velocity of jet at the outlet, but in a y direction. But we require the velocity of jet after striking in x direction because we are finding the force in x direction. So water is leaving completely in a y direction. In x direction there is a no outlet. That's why we are taking velocity of jet after striking is zero, and we putting this value of mass and velocity of different jet. So mass upon time is rho a v minus u. In bracket, velocity of jet after striking, that is v minus u, and after striking is zero. So our final equations for a force Fx is equal to rho a bracket v minus u bracket over raised to square. In a fixed plate, we are getting the equation is rho a v square. So in this case, what happened? We are just replacing the v by using the v minus u in everywhere. Means in a mass we change the v with v minus u, velocity of jet before striking is replaced the v instance of v minus u. Okay, so that's we replacing the v by v minus u. Now in a fixed plate we are not finding the work done, because when the object does not move, that means work done is zero. So in the fixed, all the cases of the fixed plate, work done is remains zero. But in the where, in a case in which the object move at a certain distance with certain velocity, in that case we are required to find out the work done. So next we find out the work done. So this is the equation of Fx. Now we use the work done per second by a jet on the plate. So work done is equal to force into distance traveled by this plate. Okay, so this is the initial condition and this is the final conditions. But in this case, all the book giving the instance of distance, they are taking the velocity. So when we multiply the Fx with the velocity, we getting the power. But in a book, they are written the work done. So we are consider it is a rate of work done per seconds. So work done, W is equal to force into distance in a direction of force. So force is Fx, and instance of distance, we are taking the u. Okay, so Fx into u. We know the equation of Fx, that is a rho a v minus u square into distance, that is a u. So this is the work done, equation of work done, and its unit is kilowatt, because this Fx in the Newton, and the velocity unit is meter per second. So all the unit of work done is Newton into meter per second. Newton into meter is equal to joule, so it is a joule per second, and joule per second is equal to watt. So it is a unit of power. So we are not considering it is a work done, but we are considering it is a rate of work done, because we have a not distance, we have a only velocity. That's why we are considering it is a rate of work done. Next we find out the efficiency for this impact of jet. So efficiency is always output upon input. What is our output? Output is the work done by the plate. So we already find out, but what is the input? So input is the water coming out from this nozzle. It is our main input. Okay, and water coming out from the nozzles have its kinetic energy. What is our equation then? Work done on a plate divided by kinetic energy at the inlet. And equation for kinetic energy is equal to 1 by 2 mv square. M means mass of water coming from the nozzles into velocity square. That is the velocity is v. So our next step is the we put the equation of work done, then mv square by 2. Now what is the mass? Mass is rho av, because it is coming out from nozzle, not the striking before the plate. From the nozzles, water coming with the velocity v. So this m is equal to rho av. Okay, so this m is equal to, we consider the rho av, not a rho av minus u, because it is our input power. So it is a mass is considered as a rho av. Thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like my video, subscribe my channels, and share with your friends.